Hello, we're here to talk to you about pro-social behavior, the basic modus. Pro-social behavior, it can be defined as any act performed with the goal of benefiting another person. Altruism is defined as the desire to help another person even if it involves a cost to the helper. Agree relationships to evolutionary psych. They can be defined as kin selection, the idea that behaviors help a genetic relative are favored by natural selection, the norm of reciprocity, which is the expectation that helping others will increase that they will help in the future, and group selection. People are more likely to survive and pass on traits if a whole group acts altruistically. Let's change the costs and rewards of helping. Altruistic behavior is based on self-interest, a desire to maximize our rewards. Gaining rewards such as feelings of self-worth, reciprocity in the future, relieve the bystander effect. Helping may be decreased when costs are high, physical danger, result in embarrassment, and take too much of our time. Overall, the social exchange theory argues that true altruism does not exist. People only help when the benefits outweigh the cost. Empathy and altruism. Pure altruism. A person's only goal is to help another person, even if there is a cost to them. Empathy. The ability to put oneself in the shoes of another and feel the emotions the other person experiences. Together, these form the empathy-altruism hypothesis. In conclusion, the three basic motives are: 1. Helping is an instinctive reaction to promote the welfare of those genetically similar to us. 2. Rewards of helping often outweigh the cost, so helping is in our self-interest. And 3. Under some conditions, empathy and compassion can promote selfless giving. So, what's next? Created using Powtoon.